What's good, boys? Been wanting to do this video for fucking forever, but I just haven't had a good cheat meal opportunity because of competing and shit. But this is cheat meal Q&A number 2. And this one's kind of focused around, the show. Competing, as it says in the title. But this one's really different because last time I just was reading like questions off my phone, but now I'm gonna be on live. And the reason I chose to do live is because I have like a little live family. I talk to you guys every single day on live, and like a lot of my subscribers are also from my live, and I wanted to show my support by like being able to have you guys in the video. I'm just gonna ask questions about the show. I'm about to start the live in a sec. And oh yeah, and then Swole Sweets sent me all this shit, dude. They sent me so much good shit. Let it focus. Oh my lord. Yo, gas. This one looks crazy, dude. And then my number one go-to, I have it every time after I compete. Hawaiian hot chicken. I'm not gonna lie, it came with 2 sandwiches. I already grubbed one and it came with fries. Demolished that shit. I just copped one of the Wood Ranch, I don't even know what these are called, but they're fucking fire. So, doesn't matter. But we're gonna start the live right now. 3, 2, 1, boom, I just went live. I'ma wait for a few viewers to get in here, and then we're gonna get right to it. I'ma get a bev, because this is crazy to eat without a bev. Cheers. Oh my god. Let's get into some fucking questions, baby. How nervous was I? I wasn't really nervous, and not even because of like, I thought I was gonna do good. I saw it the way I'd see a test. Like, I go into, like, taking a test at school, like, pretty nervous, but I'm also, like, I know what I gotta do, I've studied, I gotta get the job done, I gotta execute, and then move along with it. So, I wasn't as nervous, and just kind of fucking around with Tommy backstage made it so much more fun. Can we see your medals?
Yes, sir.
So, I'm gonna explain to you the categories. The first one was my debut, so it's, like, my first time competing in the OCB. I got first in the debut. The second category was novice. And that's like middle competitors, like you've competed a few times, but you're not like crazy experienced. I got first in that one. Show them the medal. Yes, sir. There was open category from, these are also all by height classes. So you have a shorter height class and then a taller height class. I got first in that one as well. Number one in that class and then the number one from the other class. I believe this is how it went. To be honest, I was in a fucking daze the whole time. Fought for first or second. Bro, this kid's physique was pretty fucking good. I'm not gonna lie. And I don't wanna take away anything from him, because he was such a good kid, but I was more conditioned without a doubt. I'll pull up a picture, I'll put it right here. There's a picture of him and me standing right next to each other. I'll leave it up there while I'm talking, so you guys could break it apart, but I feel like I was better conditioned. I feel like I had a little more size. That could have just been because I was taller, but his posing was A1, bro. His posing was so good. Bro, my posing, so I had competed once in an NPC show. So it's like, there's a box in the front, you walk out to the box, you hit your front, they say transition to the back, you hit your transition, you go to the back, you show them your back, they say transition front, hit the front, you're off stage. You got 15 seconds. So I'm just practicing for that. I maybe practiced posing for a total of 20 minutes all prep. So I'm like, oh, I got this in the back, I've done this before. Bro, I get up on there, and I'm holding it, I'm like, they're not saying anything, they're like, all right, right quarter turn. I'm like, what the fuck is a right quarter turn? I was like, no way, that's a classic pose. And I was like, what's going on? Dude, I know, oh my god. I just looked to my neighbor, and this is in the very first class. This isn't like the debut show, so these people don't know what they're doing either. I look to my neighbor, I just start trying to pose and like kind of copy him. So I'm like cheating on a test, bro. I felt like I was cheating on a test, and I was that dumbass that was unprepared. So I'm like kind of faking it. Bro, they knew. They even said, one of the judges was like, it's okay, it's your first time competing, it's okay if you don't know how to pose. I'm like, I'm in a full state of panic. I'm shaking now, and because of the anxiety, I can't like, I don't know what the fuck's going on, so I'm seeing me like, shit, like, fuck. But I also had a little bit of confidence, because I was like, I think I have a better physique than these guys, respectfully. But I was like, I think I could win. But I was still like, dude, this is ridiculous, bro. I hit the back, then they're just having us hold it for so long. I'm like, fuck, dude, I'm gonna shit myself. And Tommy could see from the other part of the stage, and he was like, breathe, breathe. I'm like, but I wasn't shaking, but I was just tripping, bro. I thought I was gonna black out and pass forward. But I still got the W and all those, but by the time it was time for me to compete with him, I just did not know what the hell to do. I didn't know the posing at all. And yeah, that it cost me. It cost me, I was that close to becoming a natural pro. And it cost me because of my dumbass not preparing for the posing. I was practicing NPC posing going into an OCB event. What was I thinking? Like, I'm a dumbass. Like, oh my god. And that's why I have the overall second place medal. And I'm putting it, all these medals are going to go on my shelf. This second place one I'm putting right here next to my bed, so every day I wake up, I get to look at it and realize how much of a dumbass I am and that I need to work on my posing. And I got to dial in. So this is my last mess up meal. And then, you know, the rest of the day, it's only 2 o'clock. I'm going back to it normal, going to the gym. And now I'm locking in for the rest of the month. I compete in 3 weeks. Yeah, I'm an idiot. It's a learning experience. Bro, I need to pop one of these. Oh my God. Were you stage ready that day? Yeah, bro. I don't care if I win or lose. All I care is if I go up there, my driest, most best conditioning I brought with the most amount of size I've ever had, and I brought that. I brought my best package, and I'm so proud of myself for that. But I could not display it because my posing was the dumbest thing ever.
Oh my God.
How many pounds up was I? I believe this show I was like 169, 168. Last show I was 161. So for a natural, putting on like 8 pounds, 7 pounds of muscle mass, that's pretty good. Lean, dry, contractile tissue in a year is hard to put on. So eight pounds of it, I think I gained 30 pounds on the bulk, so I'm proud of myself for that one. My lat daddy is back. Bro, listen to this. They said I could bring a name. Like I could have a name to walk out to. So when I walked on stage, they said, and here comes Tommy Brown, AKA the lat man. All right, lat man, let's see them lats, bro. I hit him with the fattest lat. I was just, and I felt, oh my God, that felt crazy. Bro, they didn't even call my name. They said, and first place, lat man. I lost my damn mind.
Oh, yeah.
Come on, baby.
Yeah.
All right, guys. I think we have a winner. Today, our winner will be
Latman. Yeah! Let's go, baby!
One of them, I was up there, and they're like, just so you know, like, we really look at posing. We're really scoring on posing. I'm like, fuck. I'm starting to shake. Show the abs if I must. They look pretty shit right now. Let's see if this one's gas.
Bro, that one's better than the last one.
What the fuck even is this? Nah, actually, last one was better.
That feels fire, though.
Yo, bro, no disrespect without trying to offend you. Are you natural?
Yes, I am.
The OCB is a drug-tested federation. You get lie detector tested first. And then if you win, you get piss tested. And then I'm gonna do blood work. I'll do that in, like, a YouTube video where I go get my blood work done. I know right now, because I got my blood work done peak bulk, I was 700 nanograms per deciliter on the dot, which is pretty average. What's my ethnicity? I'm black, white, and Puerto Rican. I'm light skinned, but I look like a fucking dark skin on stage, bro, straight up.
That show tan, bro, is different, bro.
I didn't even stay around for pictures. I went straight to the hotel and took a shower. I couldn't deal with it. I didn't want it on me. Bros every race, bro, literally straight up. I'm mixed with so much shit. I felt like distant from a lot of people because I was so like different. I used to straighten my hair, bro. I straightened my hair for a whole year. I don't really talk about that, but yeah, when I was like eighth grade, I'm gonna tell my story on YouTube. That shit's fucked up. Yeah, this one looks crazy, dude. This one looks outlandish. Look at that shit. Oh my God, that looks ridiculous.
That's busted, bro.
Do I have refeeds during prep? Yeah, I was doing once a week until I get to about 6 weeks out, then I stopped refeeding. I'm 3 weeks out, but I literally already went through a peak week, so this is kind of just put me back to where I should be. I hope this doesn't fuck my show up, but I think I'll be straight. Did you have to practice posing? Yeah, I did have to, but I didn't. I'm a fucking idiot.
Can you get a pro card at next comp?
So listen, this is what I'm thinking for the next show. I'm gonna get a posing coach, an OCB posing coach, not MVC. I'm gonna try to come in just as dry, just as conditioned. I already know what I gotta do. I did it once. I just gotta replicate it. If I do what I've always done, I'll get what I've always got. And that's a Ronnie Coleman saying. I'm a stay by that. I'm gonna do exactly the same thing, but practice really hard on my posing and stay even more regimented. That second place medal being right there is just gonna motivate me 10 times more. But I can't say I'm gonna win because there's that chance of that genetic freak pulling up, because that happened in my first show. A genetic phenomenon showed up and I was like, oh shit, well, like, I'm fucked. As long as that doesn't happen, I should be straight.
I don't make any money off this, any social media platform. Eventually I will, so I could do this full time. But right now, no money off it. I got a box,
of plain stringers that I'm gonna be making merch for you guys. So merch coming soon. I'm releasing the Ascension Aesthetic program. All the YouTube videos for Ascension Aesthetic will be able to kind of like show you what to do for the program. Like, it'll give you like a visual representation along with a very in-depth program. And then I think what I'm gonna do, because I've noticed in person, because I'm a trainer, that's what I do for work, this helps the most amount of people by far, is selling meal plans. I'll do like 100 meal plans a month. I'll have like 100 spots, and you'll text me like a few pictures of you, your height, your weight, your goals, and then I'll write you the meal plan out, and like a few other questions. It'll be like a little questionnaire, and then boom, that's personalized to you. That's like a coach. And then of course I'm only taking on 10 clients, but I'm taking on 10 clients too. Where are the protein brownies from? Another shout out to this fool. Bro, he made a picture of me. You know the picture of me holding the sword in the 7-Eleven parking lot? He put that like attached to a brownie and was like, bro, you should like post this somewhere. I was like, bet I will. But he sent me these out for free, so that was real as shit. What was my favorite part about the show? Oh my God, I can't believe I almost didn't mention this. My favorite part about the show was when I was on stage, I wasn't trying to entertain the crowd. I was trying to put on a show for my boys that went. Dude, they all had the biggest grin on their face, bro. They were looking up like yelling, like kids. It looked like a kid in a candy store times a billion. Like a kid in a candy store on fucking Molly. Yeah, that shit was amazing. Watching their reaction, bro, was beautiful, bro. Beautiful. But I'm gonna end it right there, because that shit was, that's the most memorable part. The workout before was amazing. The workout after was great. This shit is great, but job's not finished though. Tomorrow, celebration's over, right back to prep, right back to that grind. Can never get complacent. That's what I'm gonna do. W's in the chat, baby. We got hella W's in the chat. I love you, YouTube fam. I'll catch you later. I'm gonna keep talking my boys on live, but holy fuck, that pump's ridiculous. Too much sodium. All right, this is my last piece of advice. Do shit that makes you genuinely happy. Like, I'm going live right now. Like, I've never seen another creator do this shit, but this shit was so, like, off camera, we were laughing, bro. I'm, like, actually dying, bro. I see people laughing in the chat. We're all just enjoying ourselves, having a good time. So, bro, a lot of people always ask on live, too, like, how do I, like, make it? Like, how do I do this shit? Bro, just do shit you like doing. Just be genuine. Just do whatever you want to do that you think is funny, that 16-year-old you would want to watch, and you're going to do good. Fuck it if you don't do good. You get a little fan base of people who love your shit, who love you, because I love y'all, and dude, the situation is mutual. So, yeah, and then surround yourself with people you love. Bro, my abs today are so damn sore. And you're probably like, oh, it's because you're posing and shit. No, my posing wasn't what was getting me sore. I laughed so hard in the hotel that night. I couldn't stop laughing, bro. I was dying laughing. My other boy, Tommy, was like straight up dead, dude. He was just like driving like that. I was like, bro's gonna fall asleep at the wheel, bro. So much funny shit, bro. That shit was just great. A great experience. So do shit that makes you happy. I don't do this content shit at all because I want to like make it or whatever the fuck. Like, yeah, it'd be cool, but dude, I love bodybuilding. I love getting jacked as fuck. Before anything else, I want to get big. I love lifting. I didn't start lifting for content. I started lifting because I love lifting, and that's why I'm going to continue this shit. So do shit you love, and you'll never work a day in your life. You'll always have fun. Be surrounded by people you love. You'll never be able to fall into like a depressed state, because I did for a while, and my boys pulled me out of it, which is why I'm forever grateful for all my boys and all y'all, all the people on live, all the people on my YouTube, everyone on Instagram. Like, bro, straight up pulled me out of that shit. So I'm forever grateful to all you guys. So I love y'all. Thank you. Always. Later.